Hugh White, you suggest in your book that Australia must start arming ourselves with nuclear weapons. In light of the recent Cuban Missile Crisis-style standoff between the US and North Korea because of this very reason, what makes you think that our instigation of a nuclear arsenal won't have a similar effect?
Well, it's a really good question. Just to be clear, I don't actually argue that Australia should acquire nuclear weapons. What I argue is that Australia's decision about nuclear weapons, the one we made 50 years ago when we decided that we weren't going to develop them ourselves, was made in circumstances very different from the circumstances of today and even more distant from the circumstances we're going to live in, I would say, 20 or 30 or 40 years from now. And the biggest difference is that I think Asia is going to be more contested and more dangerous, and America is going to be less reliable as an ally. So at the moment, we depend on US nuclear weapons to deter any possible nuclear attack on Australia. The less confident we are of that, the less confident we are that we can rely on America to do that, the stronger the arguments for Australia to acquire.
Just briefly, why are you less confident of that, and why would Australia need its own sabre to rattle if the US still has a nuclear umbrella, as they call it?
Well, I'm less confident of America's place in Asia, primarily because of a fundamental shift in the distribution of wealth and power. America has been the dominant power in Asia for decades, as long as any of us can remember, primarily because it's been the world's strongest power, the world's biggest economy, and so on. As China grows, China's wealth challenges America's position, and its ambitions to be the leading power in Asia challenge America's capacity to sustain that position. Now, it's not Donald Trump. It's not the sort of to-ing and fro-ing in US domestic politics year by year. It's the long-term shift in wealth and power and the rise of China and its ambitions to become the leading power in Asia, which makes it seem to me very unlikely that America will be able to sustain that dominant position,
just before,
particularly looking long, far into the distance.
All right, but before I pass on to the other panellists, and we'll come back to you as well, at what point would China's military power, which seems now primarily defensive, pose a direct threat to Australia such that Australia would need nuclear weapons?
We don't know. But what we do know is that the factors which have made it so unlikely that China, or for that matter, any other major power in Asia, might threaten Australia, the things that have made Australia so secure from that kind of threat in the last few decades, are going to be less true in future. We don't know how much less true, but the choices we have to make today are ones which encompass the possibility, I think the quite significant possibility, that Australia will face both better armed and potentially more aggressive major powers in the region.
An existential threat?
Well, at least a very, very serious threat, and one which we can no longer rely on America to defend us from. You know, the fundamental shift is that for 50 years we've been able to depend on America to prevent a major power threatening Australia and to defend us if that happens. And the further ahead we look into the future, the less confident we can be of that. And we have to look a long way into the future when we talk about developing our defence forces.
OK, we're going to explore this a little more with you. Penny Wong, is it time for Australia to have a debate about whether we need our own nuclear weapons capacity, as is being suggested here?
Oh, well, on this, I don't agree with Hugh, insofar as he is actually saying that, and I take his point. I think that Australia faces a far more complex and wide-ranging set of circumstances than simply focusing on, you know, a potential attack on our territory. But I think what Hugh is grappling with is actually the right thing to grapple with, which is how do we deal with the most challenging set of external circumstances since World War II? How do we deal with the disruption we see globally and in our region? How do we deal with the fact that the two most important nations to us, you know, our friend and ally the US and China, are in different ways making decisions and acting in ways which challenge the status quo? Now, you know, that's a very short summary of a much more complex discussion, and I think what Hugh is seeking to do is grapple with it. I think we do need, as a nation, to focus very clearly on what we want in our region and how, what can we do to achieve sustaining the sort of region we want.
We're going to talk more about the general thing, but what about this strategic issue about whether or not we could ever acquire or develop nuclear weapons in this country, whether a government would ever condone that?
Well, I think in many ways it's the wrong question, because I don't actually think getting into an arms race with China is a sensible proposition. What we do want is a multipolar region in which the US stays deeply engaged, and that is in Australia's interest.